Now I just will play Skelly Drakes like that. Skelly Drakes are coming. Skelly Drakes are killing the bats. Skelly Drakes are killing the Night Witch. And guys, we actually got him so fast. Hey guys, in this video I'm showing you how to escape from mid ladder. So if you guys still in the rally, feel free to press like button and also to subscribe to the channel. So guys, actually everything starts with the right deck. So first I want to show you the right deck, and after that we are instantly jumping into the game. That's in my opinion the best lava loon deck right now for the Death Valley, especially the Valkyrie is so broken in my opinion. The Valkyrie is good against elite barbarians, against the witch, and against everything else which is coming in the Death Valley, and also having the tombstone. I recommend guys, for every one of you, please watch first. If you are using the tombstone, please watch first a tombstone guide, because then the tombstone is much more broken. And that's overall the deck. I think I don't have to tell more about this deck. So I would say let's just instantly jump into the first game and let's see if we can hopefully beat our opponent Kamikazes. So normally never do lava loon first play. I just can play Valkyrie. Actually I failed the Valkyrie kind of bit, and I'm playing against Lockbait. It looked like I'm playing against Lockbait. So the Valkyrie is so good. Also against Lockbait, I'm just going in with high Skelly Drakes and with a steep tombstone. So I'm actually able to kill the princess and also able to just kill the prince. And luckily our opponent is just level 13. So yeah, we are one level higher, so it's a small advantage for us already at the start. And now I'm able to just go in with a Lava Hound, and it's looking like he's playing with the Royal Giant. So it's a Royal Giant Mega Knight deck, probably. I don't know really, but I think we'll find out as soon as possible. So just a Mega Minion is coming back, and that's a key play against every Goblin Barrel deck in my opinion. Just going in with a Zebra like that, and also with a fireball like that. The Royal Giant actually won't deal that much damage onto us. Just going in with a tombstone. And it's looking like we are getting a lot of damage, because I actually really didn't expect it, the big push from him from his side. But at the end of the day, it's completely fine. We got his tower and he didn't even got our tower. But I hope we are facing in this video also some executioner decks, because I think these are the decks which are actually the worst, the most difficult deck right now. And it's looking like we are facing Mega Knight as well. So let's see how we can actually beat the Mega Knight. Just going in with a deep Mega Minion, and just going in with Skelly Drakes like that. So actually my Mega Minion won't really die. And now I just can go in with Lava Hound in front of him, because I actually think he is having zero spells against me. So I just can fireball that and actually already win the first game. It's so cool. I just can play a deep tombstone. Actually the tombstone won't get any damage by the tower, and also just will flawless defend the Skarmy. Just going in with the next loon strikes onto the opponent. But guys, we have to be honest, the hard decks aren't decks like that. The hard decks are decks like, for example, Executioner Witch. So I would say let's go to the next game, and hopefully we are facing some decks like that. So guys, we are into the next game against Leakless Lykis DL. And normally you hope you are not facing hard counters, but I hope I'm facing for this video some hard counters to show you how to beat hard counters. So let's see what our opponent is playing. Let's see what Lykis is playing, and it's looking like he's playing Hawk. So yeah, for sure against Hawk the guards are much more better, but normally you are not really facing the Hawk. You are normally facing Executioner Rich or so much spam. So yeah, just let us play Lava Hound at the right side, because the Firecracker is actually right now at the left side. I don't know really if the Firecracker is staying at the right side, so let's just try to find out. Balloon is going in, just playing Drakes like that onto his Firecracker, and a tower trade would be actually pretty fine for us. So it's completely fine, and the matchup isn't that good with the Valkyrie when we are honest with ourselves. Just playing a fireball onto that, because I know actually he will try to protect his Firecracker, and The start is fine, but the start is for sure not the best. So just going in with a Valkyrie to tank for the Lava Pups and let's see what he is actually doing. Am I able to get him free ground? I don't know really, guys, but we'll find out. And that's also a small tip against every Hawk deck. Just keep your Mega Minion like that and you are actually able to defend every Hawk just with one counter hit. But now it was a bit of unluck for my side, but it's fine. He spent 7 Alex here, so I think I'm able to just go in with a balloon and just zap the Tesla, and I should have won already. Let's see if we already won or if our opponent is actually one of the best players. Yes guys, he is one of the best players, but he's just at 6,600 trophies, but in my opinion that's still not that what he really wanted, because the tower is at fireball and fireball range, and for sure guys, in 30 seconds we are able to just cycle one fireball back. So playing the cheapest cards we having, playing the zap and playing also the fireball on the king tower. Let's go, what a great game. So guys, we are now into the next game. Let's see if we can win this game as well. And as I said guys, never do Lava Hound first play. You will actually always get punished, and just walking in an executioner isn't feeling really that good. So just play Tombstone, just play a zap, maybe, or also a Mega Minion, but never play a Lava Hound first play. Now he played the Valkyrie at the left side, so I'm going in same lane as well with the Lava Hound. And let's see if we can actually beat him. By the way guys, do you like the kind of content, or do you say I'm liking more the top ladder content? Please write it me in the comments. If you are saying, hey guys, I like the video, hey Carl, I'm liking the video, maybe should we do a series out of that? I don't really know already guys. So just playing a zap onto his cards, and I'm pretty hyped for your feedback. Maybe it's a good feedback, maybe it's negative feedback. I really don't expect nothing. Now just going in actually with a Mega Minion, and also going in with a Valkyrie to activate the King Tower and also to defend the Inferno Dragon flawlessly. And now it's looking like I'm playing against Lambaloon, and Lambaloon is for sure not the best matchup, but actually it's not that hard to win. And in this game I'm showing you how to. Oh no, okay guys, it's not actually fair. Okay, it wasn't that bad by my side, but I thought because of the E-Drake that it's really not splashed, but we see it's splashed, and it's good that we already activated the King Tower. But we have to also be honest with ourselves that our tower is just at 1800 HP, and he's having the Electro Drake, the Freeze, the Nado, the Inferno Drake, and also the Mega Minion, and also the Nado. So for sure not the best cards for us, but we are still trying to win the game. Mega Minion is going in, Fireball is going in. Just let us see if we can kill the Inferno Drake somehow. Yes guys, we are able. So now there's just Skelly Drakes coming in, and let's see what's coming next from him. Just Valkyrie and the Loon opposite lane are coming in. He's just having actually right now a Mega Minion into the cycle, not even one Nado. So it will be great damage, it will be two hits even without any zap. So what a great situation. Tombstone is coming in, Fireball is just coming in. So I hope I failed Fireball, sorry guys, hope I won't throw this game. Actually zap is coming in, and now I actually having no zap in the cycle, but I think I can still keep pressuring him and just play a Lava Hound at the bridge, playing a balloon at the bridge, because he's having zero freeze in the cycle, which is completely fine. Fireball is coming in, and I hope actually the Loon is connecting onto the tower. No, the Loon is not connecting onto the tower, but the E-Drake is dying, the Inferno Dragon is getting damaged. So just doing the same thing as always, playing a Deem Tombstone, playing Valkyrie like that, playing high Skelly Drake, so he is not able to freeze everything from my side. And now I actually just need to play the zap onto his tower, just need to play the fireball onto his tower. And in my opinion, it was a huge counter, but we were still able to win that game. Let's go into the next one. So guys, we are now into the next game and let's see if we can win against Medi. And yeah guys, we actually lost 0 games until now with our deck. And he's playing Golem at the back, so I need to go in with Skellydrax, Balloon at the same lane. And I just hope he isn't having any Mega Minion in the cycle, just going in with the Zap as well. So it's actually a fast tower. But normally he is also just getting my tower, so I'm not really sure if it's a good or a bad trade. But it's the only trade I were able to do. So Rek'Sai is going in. I hope there are no bats are spawning, and that's completely what I got. At the end of the day, we are getting a tower trade, and that's completely fine. When we are actually watching at the start of the video, where it just looked so bad for us. Now just Fireball is coming in, so we don't have to be afraid of our King Tower, for example. In my opinion, the Mega Minion was that good by him, so completely fine. And we don't have to be afraid of our King Tower actually, because it's not that hard really to defend a King Tower with good tombstones. I hope I can show it to you in the video. But for example, a tombstone like that, when the Golem is coming from the middle, you can kite the Golem at the third tower, at the second tower, I mean. Completely fine. Try it, guys, for yourself. So, next Balloon is going in. Lava Hound is coming in. Balloon is coming in. And now you guys are probably asking, how am I able to defend this push? So, I'm just waiting until the next wave is coming. So, just zapping now. Next Tombstone is coming in. And now I just will play Skellydrax like that. Skellydrax are coming. Skellydrax are killing the bats. Skellydrax are killing the Night Witch. And, guys, we actually got him so fast. We got his tower, and he actually just were able to get some damage. Next Rek'Sai is going in. Just okay guys, I failed the Rek'Sai a little bit. Zap is coming in. I just wanted to play the Rek'Sai as deep as possible, so the flying machine will be in my lane. So let's see how I can keep my pressure real. Skellydrax are coming in as well, so I just can kill the Nightwish completely fine. Flying machine is also not that good by him, in my opinion. So just the next Mega Minion is going in, just the next Tombstone for sure, because I wanna keep my second tower. Fireball is coming in, and also the Zap, so the Mega Minion is dying. Next flying machine is coming in. I was afraid of the flying machine, so let's see where the next flying machine is coming. I mean, hi Mega Minion. And now we are having the next Fireball, also in my opinion not the best matchup. So I would say just let us jump into the last game, and hopefully we are facing against Executioner, because Executioner is the most hardest card. Okay guys, we are now into the last game, and even if we are not facing the Executioner, firstly I want to give you a small guide how to beat the Executioner. Actually, the most important thing against the Executioner is to use your Fireball, knockback, boost the Executioner from your opponent into your Skellydrax, into your Mega Minion, and then just try to finish the Executioner. That's the only way how to win against Executioner. But in general, it's no shame when you are losing against this card. So, Mega Knight is coming from him. Skellydrax are coming in as well. Mega Minion, and here is the next Rek'Sai coming in. So, completely fine. I think it's an even trade. We are not making that big negative trade. His Ram Rider is coming in, and when the Ram Rider from your opponent is coming in the middle, you just can't kite the Ram Rider like that. Sometimes the Ram Rider will get a hit, for example right now, but it's in my opinion the best trade how to actually defend the Mega Minion, the Ram Rider, and also it's a small flex play. So we are knowing now our opponent is having the Mega Knight, so in my opinion it's kind of better for us than if you would play with the Mega with Pekka because of our Rek'Sai. So let's see how we actually are able to beat our opponent. And I think our opponent is having a big counter. Or what's your opinion, guys? He's having Inferno Drake, maybe even the Fireball. Let us find out what he's really playing. I think the Skeledrakes are doing some damage, but for sure not the same damage as he did onto us. So next Mega Man is going in, and it's looking like it will be pretty, pretty hard. And he's even playing with the arrows, which is not so good for us. And now the next Tombstone is coming in. Let's see, guys. Next Rekai is coming in as well, and just playing the next Fireball, playing the next Drakes. So I hope the Ram Rider won't connect actually onto my tower, but it's connected. No, guys, it connected. I should have just zapped that, but I didn't expect it and hit, so it was not good my side. Next Tombstone is going in. This Tombstone is actually so broken. Ram Rider didn't really charge onto my mid lane, so it's a flawless defense, but you just can make this play when the Ram Rider is actually really onto the tower, onto the bridge, plate onto the bridge. Next Rekai is coming in. Next Fireball is coming in. And it's looking like we won the game. So just playing a zap onto that. And yeah, guys, luckily we won that game. What a crazy game in my opinion. That's how to play against actually Mega Knight, Ram Rider. And I hope you guys like the kind of content. And maybe you're saying, hey Karl, I like the content really, really. So make a series out of that. Please write it me in the comments. And I would say, see you next video. Bye, guys.